darkest night and brightest day. Be at my side, O Lord. Hold my hand and guide me on my way. Sometimes the road seems long, my energy is spent. Then, Lord, I think of you when I am given strength. Walk with me, O my Lord, through the darkest night and brightest day. Be at my side, O Lord. Hold my hand and guide me on my way.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, especially those who are watching these Eucharistic celebration through the Daijiworld media, we pray God's blessings upon all of you. We are in a difficult moment, all of us know, and the readings of today on this fifth Sunday of Lent invite us to trust in the life-giving Jesus, in the merciful love of Jesus. We ask the Lord to bless us. We ask the Lord to save us. We ask the Lord to protect us. And as we are preparing ourselves to partake in this Eucharist, let us call to mind our weaknesses, our shortcomings. Let us acknowledge before the Lord that we are not worthy to partake in this Eucharist, but it is the Lord who makes us worthy, blesses us, forgives us through His merciful love. With contrite hearts together we say,
I confess to Almighty God and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins and failures, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison. Kyrie Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
Let us pray. By your help, we beseech you, Lord our God, may we walk eagerly in that same charity with which, out of love for the world, your Son handed Himself over to death. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. A reading from the book of Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, Behold, I will open your graves and raise you from your graves, O my people, and I will bring you home into the land of Israel. And you shall know that I am the Lord when I open your graves and raise you from your graves, O my people. and I will put my spirit within you, and you shall live, and I will place you in your own land. Then you shall know that I, the Lord, have spoken and have done it, says the Lord. The word of the Lord.
With the Lord there is mercy and redemption. With the Lord there is mercy and redemption. Out of the depths I cry to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. O let your ears be attentive to the voice of my pleading. If you, Lord, should mark our guilt, Lord, who would survive? But with you is found forgiveness, for this we revere you. With the Lord there is mercy and redemption. My soul is waiting for the Lord, I count on his word. My soul is longing for the Lord more than watchman for daybreak. Because with the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption. Israel indeed he will redeem from all its iniquity. With the Lord there is mercy and redemption. With the Lord there is mercy and redemption.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Those who are in the flesh cannot please God. But you are not in the flesh, you are in the Spirit. If the Spirit of God really dwells in you, anyone who does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. But if Christ is in you, although your bodies are dead because of sin, your spirits are alive because of righteousness. If the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Christ Jesus from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also through his Spirit who dwells in you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory and praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. Glory and praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me shall never die.
Glory and praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. Glory and praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The sisters Martha and Mary sent this message to Jesus. Lord, the man you love is ill. On receiving the message, Jesus said, this sickness will not end in death, but in God's glory. And through it, the Son of God will be glorified. Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus, yet when he learned that Lazarus was ill, he stayed where he was for 2 more days before saying to the disciples, "Let us go to Judea." On arriving, Jesus found that Lazarus had been in the tomb for 4 days already. When Martha heard that Jesus had come, she went to meet him. Mary remained sitting in the house. Martha said to Jesus, "If you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now, whatever you ask of God, he will grant you." "Your brother," said Jesus to her, "will rise again." Martha said, "I know he will rise again at the resurrection on the last day." Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" "Yes, Lord," she said. "I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who was to come into this world." Jesus said in great distress with a sigh that came straight from the heart, "Where have you put him?" They said, "See how much he loved him." But there were some who remarked, "He opened the eyes of the blind man. Could he not have prevented this man's death?" Still sighing, Jesus reached the tomb. It was a cave with a stone to close the opening. Jesus said, "Take the stone away." Martha said to him, "Lord, by now he will smell. This is the 4th day. Jesus replied, "Have I not told you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone. Then Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, "Father, I thank you for hearing my prayer. I knew indeed that you always hear me, but I speak for the sake of all these who stand around me, so that they may believe it was you who sent me." When he said this, he cried in a loud voice, "Lazarus, here, come out." The dead man came out, his feet and hands bound with bands of stuff and a cloth around his face. Jesus said to them, "Unbind him, let him go free." Many of the Jews who had come to visit Mary and had seen what he did believed in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, we heard the Gospel proclaimed just now from the Gospel of John. Gospel of John has several signs, totally 7 signs of Jesus. And this is the last sign, the resuscitation of Lazarus. The first sign being the sign that is the miracle at Cana, the wedding feast of Cana. What is the message from the Gospel of today that we can take home? Maybe 3 or 4 points, a short reflection on this text will help us to grasp the message of the Gospel of today. Look at the context of the text. The context is Lazarus is dead. The sorrow, the sadness of death pervades the family of Martha and Mary and Lazarus, and also the entire village, because many have come to pay visit to Martha and Mary to console them. So the situation where gloom, sadness prevails, Lazarus is dead. So in the context of this situation where there is gloom, sadness, death, Jesus enters. When we look at the situation today in the world, something similar context we feel. The entire city, the entire world seems as though dead. We cannot visit anyone. We cannot go to the other house. We are restricted. We feel as if we are dead. The entire society is dead. The entire nation is dead. The entire world is dead. We call it lockdown. Another aspect is the situation of death. Gloom prevails. So what is the context of the gospel is also our context. Is it not that we experience today? In this context, how does Jesus speak? What is the message of Jesus? When Lazarus is dead, Martha feels the absence of God. That's the second point I want to reflect. In the moment of suffering, the absence of God. When Jesus comes, Martha says, Lord, if you were here, my brother would not have died. I felt your absence. During our suffering, we do feel like Martha, that Jesus is not there. If Jesus was there, this would not have happened. That was the feeling of Jesus also on the cross. My God, why have you abandoned me? Why have you forsaken me? In the suffering, the human predicament is feeling the absence of God. Is not that our experience even today? As this rampant coronavirus is spreading, we ask, Lord, where are you? We feel your absence. That is our experience. Like Pope was commenting yesterday in the Urbi et Orbi blessing, the text from the gospel where Jesus calms the sea. Jesus was sleeping and the disciples were waking him up. Lord, why are you sleeping? Are you not bothered? So the human predicament in suffering is that we feel the absence of God. But Jesus assures, I am not absent, I am present. We shall take the third point where Jesus comes at the tomb of Lazarus, and coming near the tomb, Jesus weeps. The shortest sentence in the gospel, Jesus wept. Many around him comment saying that he loved Lazarus so much. True. Jesus weeps and Jesus wept at the tomb of Lazarus. In the Gospels, we find two times Jesus weeping. One in the Gospel that we heard today, and another in Luke chapter 13, verse 34, where Jesus weeps over the city of Jerusalem. I find Jesus is weeping even today. Not only looking at our homes and our cities, but looking at the entire world, Jesus is weeping. Meaning, Jesus is weeping with us. As he wept with Martha and Mary, he is weeping with us who are suffering because of this pandemic, because of this trauma, because of this difficulty. When we are weeping, Jesus is also weeping with us. That is the greatest truth of the Bible. Jesus suffers with us. Jesus weeps with us. When Jesus is weeping with us, he is giving us support in our suffering. He is not abandoning us. He is not leaving us. Rather, he is supporting us. He is with us. He weeps in and through us. So Jesus is with us. And the last point, Jesus brings out Lazarus alive. Jesus gives life to Lazarus. The dead is given life. That is what we have heard in the first reading from the book of Ezekiel, second reading from the letter to the Romans, as well as the gospel. All the three readings speak about God as life and not death. Although our experience is death, gloom, sadness and sorrow, our Lord, our God, is life. He is the spirit of life. From the reading of the book of Ezekiel, we heard that through His Spirit, the Lord will give life to each one of us. And from the letter to the Romans, we hear the Spirit of life is in us and He gives life to each one of us. In this moment of sadness, should we not trust in the Lord who is the giver of life? Cross is not the end. Suffering is not the end. But the resurrection is the culmination of our life. That we do not end ourselves in the grave, but we have life. Even when we are going through these sad moments, a death-like feeling, we trust in the Lord who is the giver of life. We ask the Lord to give us life, to renew us with that strength, with that joy, so that we are able to live our life praising the Lord, glorifying the Lord. May the Lord help us in our day-to-day life. Give us life so that we are able to live for Him and for one another. Amen. Kindly stand, let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and He is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let our response be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Pope, the bishops, the clergy, and the religious, that the Holy Week, which is close at hand, may be a time of spiritual renewal and interior purification for all the Church, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all Christians may consider the remaining days of Lent and the imminent arrival of the Holy Week as a time of immediate preparation for the celebration of Easter, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Catholics all over the world who have been observing the period of Lent as a favorable time of repentance and conversion, may experience the loving presence of the Father who is ever merciful to sinners, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Catholic preachers, teachers, and authors, that they may expound the mysteries of the Kingdom of God in a manner that is intelligible to the people, so that they may become aware of every discipline concerning our belief, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us present in this Eucharistic assembly, that enlightened by the Word of God, we may firmly put our trust in the Lord Jesus, whose resurrection and return to His Father are the hallmarks of our faith, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us now silently pray for all our intentions. We pray that the Lord gives us joy and happiness, His life-giving Spirit, particularly during these moments of this pandemic. We pray for all those who are affected by the coronavirus. We pray for all those who are taking care of the patients in the hospitals or at home. We pray for all those administrative bodies, the Department of Police. We pray for our national leaders that they may take the right decision in the right moment. Brothers and sisters, we pray for all your intentions in this infant Jesus shrine. Many of us would wish to come and join the celebration here in this shrine, but we assure you, the Carmelite fathers and brothers will pray for you in this shrine for all your intentions, particularly those who are going through difficult moments in their lives, those maybe the health problems, or even these days when it is difficult to meet the daily needs. We bring all your intentions at the feet of the infant Jesus. We make these prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, that this sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy Church.
Hear us, Almighty God, and having instilled in your servants the teachings of the Christian faith, graciously purify them by the working of this sacrifice, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim.
Hosanna in the highest.
indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Peter Paul, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Particularly, we pray for all those who have died in the world due to this coronavirus. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Trusting in the merciful love of our Heavenly Father, we now pray in the words our brother Jesus Christ has given us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, Lord, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other peace of Christ.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free us from all our sins and from every evil. Keep us faithful to your teaching and never let us be parted from you. Behold Jesus, the life-giving Lord, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are we who are going to receive him.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all life everlasting.
So wonderful, Jesus is so wonderful. God's love is so wonderful, so wonderful for you and for me. God is always kind when you're lonely. Keep him closer to your heart. He will give you peace. He will give you rest. If you have his love in your heart, God's love is so wonderful. Jesus is so so wonderful, so wonderful for you and for me. Put your trust in God, everybody, every day and every hour. He will give you joy, he will give you hope. If you have his love in your heart, God's love is so wonderful. Jesus is so wonderful. God's love is so wonderful, so wonderful for you.
Let us pray. We pray, Almighty God, that we may always be counted among the members of Christ, in whose body and blood we have communion, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Special blessing, kindly bow your heads. Bless, O Lord, your people who long for the gift of your mercy, and grant that what at your prompting they desire, they may receive by your generous gift, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit in me. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit in me. Wash me, cleanse me, purify me, make my heart as white as snow. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit in me. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit in me. Along with your loving Son, bless, O Mary, everyone.
By the sign of the cross, deliver us, O Lord, from all that is evil. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.